Hey everybody, Dorilla here. Thank you so much for joining me for another episode of the Men of Yoshiwara Kikuya. We are doing the sub-scenarios for the guys now, and actually Kairo is all I have left. And he has four scenarios, so we'll do two each video. So, this one we will start with the flower that hides a sweet poison. Tulips are poisonous. Kind of like you, says Kairo. You get depressed, but then... The flower that hides a sweet poison. I was on my way back from an errand for my mother, taking an order from the flower wholesalers. I was hurrying home when...
Misao.
I stopped at the sound of Kagero's clear, familiar voice. Bathed in warm spring light, Kagero sat with his back straight on a bench outside of a tea store. Hi, Kagero. Are you on your way home from training?
Yes, from fencing. Are you on your way back from another errand?
Yeah.
Judging from your appearance, it didn't go too well. Did you run there and fall over in front of them or something?
What? How did you know? Kagero chuckled, then putting his teacup to the side, he stood up. Then he knelt down in front of me and touched my skirt with his slim finger. What was he doing?
There's powder on your skirt. Flour, maybe. Did you fall over at a store that sells flour?
Yeah, I went to the flour wholesaler and... I tripped over a bag of flour. Kagero snickered and started brushing the flour off my skirt with his hand. It's fine. I'll get it off myself.
You're one of Kagero's valuable customers. Nothing wrong with an attendant like me cleaning you off.
But we're not in Yoshiwara. Young men stood out, whether they liked it or not. And when that young man was so extraordinarily beautiful, people couldn't help but look. That's enough. This is embarrassing. Everyone's looking at us.
It's more embarrassing being with someone that has flour all over her.
Well, I'll just be going home now. Seeing me in confusion trying to get away, Kagero started laughing.
But the sweet soy dumplings in this tea shop are simply delicious.
Huh?
Won't you try some?
Kagero spoke, looking me in the eyes emphatically. Fine. You're being, how do I say, kinda unfair.
Why? I just want to treat you to some limited edition dumplings.
I don't mean about dumplings. Kagero knew that. Whenever I was with him, my heart would skip a beat. That's why he knew if he asked me to, I'd do whatever he wanted.
I'm only kidding. I get it.
Do you?
A weirdo like you who picks me, a mere attendant, would stay here just for some dumplings. It's because there's something more intriguing than dumplings that you're sitting here with me.
Panicked, I tried to stop my cheeks from flushing.
Oh, look at that flower shop over there. It's quite rare to see flowers from the West.
Huh? I spoke confused before turning my eyes to where Kagero was looking. The flower shop had put some cup-like flowers in amongst the lilies and mums I was used to seeing.
That flower, it's called a tulip. Has it caught your eye?
Kagero's voice, as usual, has a sarcastic edge. Are you enjoying yourself by making fun of me? And after I'd been so happy to run into him, a little offended and upset, I looked away from Kagero.
The way you react to things is just so funny. Do you not like it?
You'll make a great courtesan one day, Kagero. He was already so good at toying with girls just with his words.
But then I wouldn't be able to enjoy myself here with you like this anymore, could I?
Surprised, I looked up, just as someone from the tea shop bought out some sweet dumplings and tea.
They are really very good dumplings, Misao.
Thank you. I guess I'll have one. Like Kagero said, the dumplings were sweet and delicious. Suddenly, Kagero spoke quietly.
I knew you'd come by here.
How?
I was looking at those rare tulips when you ran around that corner earlier. I thought if I waited here, you'd come back this way, and for some reason, I just couldn't leave.
Well, why?
Because I wanted to talk to you.
He wanted to talk to me?
Misao, those flowers called tulips. They're poisonous. When Kagero picked up an academic-looking book he put aside, and after placing it on his knees, started flipping through the pages. Look, it says more about it here. There's a picture of a flower that looks just like the tulip. Is that a book about botany? It's a book about poison. What? This book says that the tulip has a poison that's bad for your heart. Kagero turned to me and peered deep into my eyes. It reminds me of you. Do you mean to say that I'm poisonous? I mean that if you were a flower, you'd be a tulip. Kagero shut the book and walked over to the flower shop. Then he asked the florist to remove the leaves from a single tulip and came back holding it. If you take the leaves from the flower, it's just like a cute hairpin. Kagero gently tucked the yellow tulip into my hair. It looks good on you. Kagura is busy tonight, but please look at this flower and think about Yoshiwara.
Even after I got home, I couldn't stop thinking about Kagero's mysterious words. Am I like a poisonous flower? Unable to take it as a compliment, I thought about it for a long time. I couldn't help myself. I ended up going to Yoshiwara again that night. Feeling miserable, I arrived at Kikuya, where Iroha greeted me with a sad smile.
Misao, Kagura is not free tonight.
I know, I want to see Kagero.
Well, well. Unfortunately, Kagero is still just an attendant. He's unable to stand in for Kagura.
Yes, but I still just want to see him.
Iroha, the room at the back is free. I'll show Misao there. No, Kagero. That's only for Kagura to do. The customer's dead drunk, so the party's going to end soon. Until then, I can serve her. All right, please show her to the back room.
The room that we entered was empty. I could hear Kagero's footsteps echoing in the stillness of the room. I could even hear the rustle of his clothes in what was usually lively quarters. What a quiet place.
We don't usually use this room unless we have to, since you can't see much of the garden.
You mean like now?
Because Yoshiwara is enclosed by a wall. Some people use it as a place to discuss secrets.
The wall that isolated the courtesans was a wall of protection for some people. I'm sorry for having made you have to use such a room. Kagero told me that Kagura was busy today, but I'd wanted so much to talk about what he'd said earlier today, I couldn't help myself. I've acted really childishly.
Hmm?
I'm Kagura's customer, so I knew that I wouldn't be able to come here just to see you, and yet... I spoke in a barely audible voice when Kagura giggled. Is it that funny? Have I been that stupid?
When I put that tulip in your hair, I knew you'd come here, and now here we are.
So that's why you told me I was like a poisonous flower? Seeing me start getting annoyed, Kagero snickered. Then he quietly took out a paper bag, hidden inside his clothes.
Open your mouth.
Huh?
If you open your mouth, I'll give you the answer you want.
Kagero chuckled as he spoke. Though anxious, I opened my mouth slowly. Kagero took something round and brown from the paper bag, then put it between my lips.
It's a foreign candy called a cookie. It's really sweet and tasty.
Though I had no idea what he was talking about, I bit down on the cookie with a crunch. It's good. A fragrant sweetness I'd never tasted before filled my whole mouth.
A tulip was used to make that cookie.
A poisonous? Kagero rubbed my back as I unintentionally choked.
It's a tulip specially grown to be edible, so there's no poison in it.
You should have told me that first. My eyes were watering as I choked, as Kagero continued gently rubbing my back.
Tulips are poisonous, but the edible kind are used as sweeteners in candy.
That's your answer? I didn't get it. What was Kagero thinking?
You're like the spirit of a tulip. There's a poison that rules over my heart, and it's captivatingly sweet.
Behind his voice lurked the trembling darkness of a man.
That's why I'm getting so strange. Maybe it's because I'm still just inexperienced.
Kagero embraced me and pulled me close to him.
What if someone sees us like this?
I blurted out in a panic and a sudden embrace. Kagero kissed my temple, then whispered,
"This room is used for secret meetings. It's even soundproof."
But Kagero...
The rules of Yoshiwara said that once you choose your courtesan, you can't change your mind. Even so, Kagero pulled me in at the waist and pushed me down on the floor.
"I can make you happy, too."
Though he was young, Kagero was a lean, muscled swordsman, so strong that I couldn't escape.
"But I..."
"You're sweet and tasty. I can't help myself."
"Kagero..."
When I tried to resist, he breathed into my ear. A ticklish feeling ran through my body.
"Though I'm still an attendant, even I know how to make a girl happy. Even you. I could... right away."
But we can't break the rules of Yoshiwara."
"How naughty of you, then, driving me crazy like this."
Stop!
I twisted my body when he lightly bit down on my exposed neck.
"Do you not like it?"
My heart beat so hard in my chest, I thought it'd fall out.
That's not what I want."
"Then, Misao, kiss me like we're lovers, for tonight."
"Kagero."
Softly looking nervous, his face drew closer.
"Close your eyes. It's embarrassing to be stared at when you're about to kiss someone."
When he phrased it like that, Kagero seemed like an adult, and yet also a child. He kissed me somewhat awkwardly, and then pulled me close and held me tight.
"Let's stay like this. Please let me hold you until Kagero gets here."
"Kagero..."
After a while, Kagero propped himself up with one hand on the tatami mat when he stared at me.
"Everything today is a secret, and this is to stop you from telling anybody."
"Yes."
His way of stopping me from telling was to kiss me sweetly on a secret night in dark Yoshiwara. I became Kagero's secret wife. The flower that hides a sweet poison. The end.
When they say that
she became his wife, they make it sound like they slept together, but we know they didn't because the main storyline covered that part. I don't know, that's kind of confusing. But it was a cute little story anyway. Alright, now we'll go for a sign. Coming home from shopping, Kagero sees something he wants. I don't know. Kagero says he wants to see the ocean? Oh, I get another gallery picture for him. While you and Kagero are on the way home from shopping, he suddenly says he wants to go to the ocean. A sign. A while passed since Kagero began staying with us and helping our business. Summer was about to come.
"We have to hurry or all the good products will be gone."
"I'm almost ready, so just wait a little more."
"You're unbelievable, making me wait like this."
Though he spoke harshly, Kagero-san was still waiting for me at the entrance with a smile. A large commercial ship from a foreign country was coming to the port today. It was decided that we would head there after my mother asked us to go out and buy products.
"It's a very large ship."
"It only stops here once a year."
"And since I was bound to Yoshiwara, that would explain why I've never seen it before."
"It looks like merchants have already begun buying things over there. Let's go."
"Okay, Misao-san."
Naturally, I put my hands on Kagero-san's arm, and he held my body close to him.
"How about this glass hairpin?"
"It looks nice. It has a rare color, too."
"What is this?"
I took some beautiful pottery work into my hand and opened its cover.
"It looks like colored powder or rouge." "Look, didn't I give that to you before, Misao?" "It was from this country."
"Ah, I remembered the Kamachi rouge that he bought for me before." Kagero put the bright red rouge on my lips with his hand. Then, just as I looked at Kagero-san's face, he had a beautiful smile on his face and extended his hand to my cheek.
"Kagero-san."
"I felt that you have come to know a little about makeup compared to before, Misao-san."
He smiled meanly.
"The color of those lips and cheeks of yours. Your makeup today seems a little different from usual. I like this color.
I knew we were going out together, so I put my all into preparing. Though today we came here to buy products for our business.
You don't need to be embarrassed about it, do you?
My eyes wavered as he stared at me. Seeing me get embarrassed by this small thing, Kagura chuckled at me.
Well, we should hurry and look at all the products while the sun is still out.
Around the merchant vessel, I could see young men, a rare sight outside the red light district. The men from the mainland usually didn't want to come near this island. They must be foreign merchants and sailors who don't believe the superstitions. How rare. Though curious about it, I focused on finding the items that I was looking for. This one, and this red hairpin too.
This one? This color seems to look really good on you, miss.
The blue-eyed merchant tried to reach his hand out to my hair. Then Kagero came in front of me to distance me from that hand.
Please, pack these quickly. We're busy with work.
I'm sorry. Kagero-san? He had a stiff expression on his face.
Let's go and look at the next products.
Yes. Kagero-san's arm held me with a slightly greater strength than before. By the time that we finished buying products, the sun had already set. I could faintly smell the sea breeze. Shall we go back soon?
A little more.
Huh? Kagero-san pulled my sleeve as I was about to leave the port.
There's a comfortable wind blowing, so why don't we talk a little?
Okay. I held the hand that he extended to me, and we started to walk together. We left the port that was still crowded after sunset and went somewhere with few people.
I want to see the ocean.
The ocean? His unexpected words made me want to question him in return, but Kagero didn't answer me. As usual, his beautiful back stood straight up. It looked like his eyes were smoldering, but this was probably because of the sun's orange color. His hand that I was holding felt oddly sweaty. We walked towards the beach at the end of the island. We could see the ship over the horizon as it left the port.
It's quiet. The hustle and bustle of the port seems so unreal. I thought the sounds of the waves would be louder than this.
Isn't the beach at night supposed to be like this?
Is it? I didn't know that.
Over the horizon, Kagero-san saw the boat as it emitted a dim light, and he narrowed his eyes.
That ship is going back already.
I heard they stopped by this island since they're on their way to the mainland.
It was so crowded around the ship during the day. How lonely.
But the light of the ship as it leaves is beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, that soft dim light is different from the light of the red light district. It's not for show. It's just quiet and beautiful.
Kagero-san softly entangled his fingers with my hand. He looked into my face with his clear eyes. After a while, he sniffed his nose a little. What happened?
Nothing. I just feel that I wasn't myself before, even though we came here on business today. I feel embarrassed about being jealous.
What are you talking about?
Misao, I can't believe you. I'm actually grateful that you're that dim. You didn't even notice that you made me feel like that. But perhaps having such feelings is a happiness that can be had by normal people.
Though surprised, his eyes were kind in every respect. His expression had become softer than it was when he was in the red light district.
I can be with you day and night like this, as if it's a regular thing. I can see the ocean with you like this.
Kagero-san.
I never got a good look at the ocean before I started working for a shipping agent. As I experience greater freedom, it makes me remember with increasing detail that I was a gentleman of the night in the red light district for so long.
His eyes that were already filled with fearless light reflected the light of the ship from afar. The clear and age-appropriate boyish light of his eyes was somehow fleeting. It made me feel a little lonely. I firmly gripped his hand. Kagero-san.
Hey, you're making that face again.
Huh?
Because you make that cute face, I...
Then he suddenly hugged my body with greater strength than he appeared to be exerting. Kagero-san. His painful embrace made my body squirm.
I won't let you go. I will never release my arms.
What are you saying all of a sudden?
You are still acting like you don't know what this is all about. You have always been like this, Misal. You smile gently at everyone and with your innocent and cute face. Not only to me. The Red Light District was the same. Gentlemen tried to seduce you because of your smile. But at the same time, I was just an apprentice. You had no idea just how frustrated I was to see the other gentlemen looking at you like that.
The color of the boy's eyes flickered with intense emotion. Within this dignified and pure person, there certainly existed intense feelings for me.
Today, too, that foreign merchant was making eyes at you, Misal. So it made me very worried. That was enough for jealousy to rear its ugly head. Misal, you are mine, and only for me. But why are you doing this to me?
Kagero-san, it wasn't my intention to do that.
Are you testing me?
He fiercely glared at me with eyes that were helplessly irritated. And at the next moment, his lips twisted in an alluring manner. His smile brought chills down my spine. He was someone who would behave like this?
Misal, if you look at anyone but me, I...
His hot lips traced the line of my neck, and...
Bite.
Huh? Kagero-san bit my neck. I felt a sweet pain accompanied by a numbness. The small red mark left on my neck was certainly a sign of the jealousy that Kagero-san showed me. I wonder how much time we spent here. The ship that we saw over the horizon was gone, and before we knew it, only the moonlight shined upon us. Kagero-san, who showed me a different part of himself, was hugging my shoulders in silence now.
What?
Because of the moonlight, Kagero-san's lips looked more mature than usual. Would you like to come to the ocean again? Next time we'll come during the day.
As long as it's just you and me.
His lips formed an arc, and this excited me at the core of my heart. The breeze blowing from the ocean was very comfortable, but my face was somehow hot. Maybe it's because the summer was coming soon. It seems like this summer will be a hot one.
Yes. When I met you for the first time, the cherry blossoms were still blooming, though.
As he said that, the boy had a cynical look on his face. He's now back to his normal self, after previously showing me a different side of himself.
I have an idea. When we come next time, why don't we try to go into the ocean? But, as I said before, I don't have much experience of enjoying the beach, so... You should teach me how to swim, Misal.
What? You want me to teach you, Kagero-san?
It might be fun to learn something from you every now and then.
Do you think I can do that?
Who knows? And by the way, I'm a selfish student. So, how shall I make trouble for you?
Kagero-san smiled mischievously. Well...
Don't make such a troubled expression. That's why I always make fun of you.
He looked at me contemptuously and laughed at me.
Don't take everything that I say today so seriously. I just wanted to make fun of you.
After saying that, he suddenly looked up at the moon that was shining in the darkness.
I feel reluctant to do so, but we should go back. Soon. Don't you think so, Misal?
I kept a bitter smile on my face as he once again held my shoulder close to him. His scent softly tickled my nose. Unlike the sea breeze, I could smell something sweet in his scent. And like that, we headed home, snuggled up against each other. Now we're closing in on the grand finale. Well, there's not really a grand finale, but it's going to be the true end of our playthrough with Yoshiwara. And that will be the last two videos with Kagero. So, join me again for that if you please. And I hope to see you in some of my future videos, whether it be that or something else. I'd be so grateful for any likes, comments, or subscriptions, or shares with your friends to show some support. Thank you so much for joining me, and I wish you all health, happiness, and safety. Dereli signing out. Bye-bye, everybody.